Hello everyone, I'm Jens Bogren, and I'm gonna walk you through the brand new Ampknob BDH bundle from Bogren Digital. These three Ampknob plugins are based on three different versions of a very, very popular high-gain amplifier that I use all the time here at Fascination Street Studios. It follows the Ampknob concept, which means that you have just one knob and a finished sound that I've crafted for you. I'm gonna show you exactly how easy to get a fantastic sounding guitar tone out of these plugins. Here I have the BDH bundle promo song, and let's check out that mix a little bit, and then I'm gonna walk you through the features of these plugins. So this really cool promo song that we have for the BDH bundle is written and performed by Federico Escari. All right, so here I have my mix session. It consists of some drum tracks, bass tracks, three guitar tracks. Usually I would perhaps do two or four, like left, right, or two on left and two on right. But for this one, since we have three plugins, I wanted to use three instead, one for each amp that I use as my main rhythm guitar sound. And also there is a point of doing that when you do promotion material for a video that goes on Facebook and YouTube or whatever, it can actually increase your mono compatibility doing so. And then there's a bunch of effect tracks here as well to spice up the song a little bit. You can actually download these stems along with the raw DI to check it out yourselves and compare it to whatever amp you have out there. Let's bring up the amp knobs. So we have one per track. Left and right, I'm using the BDH III for left, the 5169 for right. And then the center one, I'm using this 6606 plus. The 5169 is like the original incarnation of this high gain amp. And we have spared no pain trying to recreate that exact high gain tone that defined a whole generation, more or less. The next one here, the 6606 plus, is a little bit more of a modern sounding amp, but this is a special one because this one is custom modified to my specs. So it sounds like nothing else out there on the market. It's very cool. It doesn't have as thick distortion tone maybe, but it creates bite and spits and works really, really well inside of a mix, in my opinion. Sounds really cool. This white one here, the BDH III, is a later incarnation of this amp. It has the most modern sound. It's pretty dense, very rich in the low end, and just works fantastic for most tasks. I've been using that amp a lot in my productions. So with these three amps, you have a whole toolbox of sounds to use for your mixing. So what I'm gonna do here, we have the mix. I have the guitars, the DIs. You can just listen to those DIs here for a little bit. We have for the left side. We have for the right side. And then we have the center here. So let's just put these on. Like, this is default settings. Just how the plugin loads up, including a pedal in front of the amp, a pedal switch that you can turn on and off like this. But this is the default state with the pedal on. And let's have a listen. So this is without anything. I don't have any plugins on. This is just the raw sound. These rhythm guitar tracks, they go to Rhythm's master here, where I have, as you can see here, there are no plugins or anything. There's just some automation here for a little thing where it ramps up. The rest is just like this. There are a little bit of EQ to the whole mix. You can see that. These channels go out to my summing mixer, and it's more for me to be able to gain stage properly. It's part of my normal mix chain. And then they come back into the system through a outboard compressor, an SSL compressor. It's just nudging a little bit, a dB or so. And then on the mix input, I do have this EQ here for full transparency, which is pretty normal thing. I think to fit the guitars even better into the mix, maybe I would need to bring up a little bit more highs perhaps, or massage them, but already like this, it just works. And since this is a pretty dense type of riffing, quite low tuned, I figured the more dense distortion amps here would go better for left and right, but I could basically just swap this out. We can do that. Let's just remove them all. And then on the left one, let's put on the we have Bogren Digital 6606 Plus default settings. It's a lot of distortion. You can hear some noise there from the DI, but that's fine. For the right channel, let's choose something else instead. Let's I guess we can do the BDH III. And then for the center channel, we could use the 5169 instead. All default settings, just how they load up. Let's see how that sounds. Cool. I can hear a little bit more harmonics and this spit and wildness now in my left channel here from the 6606. But that also works really, really fine. Let's check this out a little bit. If we listen to the 6606, let's put it down, let's turn off the pedal. It's still possible to get like really, really distorted results. And if we turn on the pedal, all right, so let's dive into the sounds of these a little bit further. First, the BDH III, pretty tight distortions. If we listen a little bit to it, and then we could try to remove this pedal. And if we turn on this pedal, it focuses the sound a little bit. It crushes the low end and packages it a bit, and that usually works really fine inside a mix. I would say that most of the time I have some sort of pedal in front of my amps. This is not exactly your Stratocaster clean sound from those DIs, which these amps actually handle very well as well. If we check out the 5169, this one is a little bit similar to the BDH III in terms of like tight distortion, but it has a little bit of a nastier, meaner sound to it. Let's check it out without the pedal. Yeah, and depending on your listening environment, you may hear quite a bit of difference or not so much difference between the pedal on and off. So what the pedal is doing here as well is that it's tightening up the low end a little bit and gives yet another level of push and amount of distortion. Usually it's better to try to dial in the amount of distortion inside the mix. Otherwise I tend to find that it's easy to get too much distortion on your amps. These amps have plenty of it. Let's check out the 6606. You can turn off the pedal. Just listen to the little cleaner stuff. Then we can turn on the pedal. Pretty mean sounding. Yeah, that's it. I mean, you have the pedal on, the pedal off, and the knob, and off you go. Make sure that your input level is cool. If you want an even cleaner sound, you can drop the input a little bit, maybe. So beyond the pedal on off, this one knob input and output adjustment, there is a built-in tuner. Works really well. I fine-tuned it myself. And there is a cab feature, which is a little bit developed for this generation of amp knobs, where you can choose the built-in matched cab, which I recommend. What is a matched cab, you might wonder? Well, it's a cabinet that I've chosen to work really well with the sound of the amp. It's a full recording chain, a selection of microphones that I've blended to taste and worked in with some post EQ, and created that chain as an impulse response, and that's three different ones for these three different amps. But if you want to investigate this and use your own IRs or third-party IRs, maybe from Bogren Digital, you can choose to do so by clicking here and do load custom IR. What we see here with those beautiful names is actually my own rhythm guitar pack. I also have some Cola signature ones here that I tend to use, or more specific ones for cleans and lead sounds. Because the matched cabs here for all these three amps is targeted mostly towards rhythm guitars, I would say. If you have some external IR loader that you prefer, where you can perhaps mix a bunch of IRs, you could also choose the no cab function. Most of the time, myself here, I would just go with the matched cab, be happy with it. Beyond this, there is also some settings here. First and foremost, I would say it's the gate. It's on by default. If you want to have really tight chugging and genting or whatever, you might want to bring up the gate threshold a little bit. You can also turn it off completely. Other preferences here, you can actually choose between high quality, which is my normal mode, I would say, and what we call normal quality, which is lower CPU usage. So if you have an issue with the CPU spikes while recording, or if you want to record at the lowest latency and your computer can't really handle it, then I would recommend that you go in and choose the normal mode, which still sounds really, really good. What you could do is that you record in the normal low CPU mode and then mix or bounce in the high quality mode. For most people, just using high quality is going to be completely fine. What's worth mentioning though is that even if you run this normal mode online or record with it, as soon as you do an offline bounce of your mix or of your track, it's always going to be the highest quality under the hood. So that's it regarding the features of the plugins. If we go to standalone, meaning that you don't load it as a plugin inside your DAW, but just as a regular freestanding software, there are a few more options here. You can see that there is this recording button, and that's also new for this generation of amp knobs. We call it the Riff recorder. That means that you don't have to load up your DAW or anything. You can just start the software Riff with a really, really cool responsive sound and get the inspiration flowing. Press the record button, and then when you're done, turn it off, and you can save that as a recording. Freaking great Riff 3. save. Do not press don't save if it's a freaking good riff, by the way. And then you have a folder next to the recording button. If we click that one, it opens up my riff IDs. And there we have it, freaking great Riff 3. It was just slightly better than cool Riff 3. For this standalone version, there is also a metronome, because you do need to keep your tempo, right? It's a pretty advanced one where you can choose the division of beats and highlight accents. You can choose to speed up and stuff. I think we have another video for these features that you can check out. Different metronome sounds and whatnot, volume for the metronome. So really good stuff for the standalone version. Riff Recorder, pretty unique stuff. Try it out. That's it. These walkthrough videos for amp knobs are so fast because the plugins are just that. They're designed to be fast and get you a great sound immediately. Check out the links below where you can get your trials of all these three plugins and also the stems for this promo song. See you around.